everyone, I'm Lauren from My Something Beautiful Life. So a couple months ago, Clever Fox sent me both of these planners to review, and I just thought it would be fun now that Clever Fox is starting to get into the ring system or binders to just show how these can be combined and create a customized planner that just has everything that you need in it. I was really excited when I first saw that Clever Fox released the weekly planner in a binder system. And then when they released the budget planner too, I started thinking about all of the different possibilities if they keep this up and just keep releasing their planners in binder systems. I do know that the weekly planners are available just with the inserts without the actual binder itself. The budget one, I believe, only comes in a set right now. But I'm really hoping that not only they continue this with some of their other planners, but also that they continue to just do the inserts so that you can pick and choose the ones that you want so that it just gives you more options to customize your planner. So I have this pile of stuff that I've just gotten from my stash. These are all A5, so they're a little bit different in sizing than these are, but just it's not too bad, so I think it should be fine. I didn't grab anything new. This is just all stuff that I had laying around. But I thought it would be fun to see how we can combine these two and just create a full planner system. So this is the budget planner, and then this is the weekly planner. And I think I want to use this binder. It is a little bit smaller. I'll show you them both together. Not just in like the dimensions of it. I mean, you can see that the budget binder does come out a little bit more, but the thickness too. The budget one does have a bigger ring in it than the weekly planner does, and I think that's because they have the budget envelopes in here, while the weekly one just has the weekly pages, so it doesn't need to be as big. But I kind of like this size a little bit better right now, so I'm going to see if I can use this one. If I end up having too much in there, then we'll switch over to the pink one, but I think I'm gonna try for the periwinkle blue one right now. And we will just see how this turns out. So the first thing I want to do is try to decide how much of each planner that I want in here. I'm thinking I'm going to aim for about 3 months of each, but we'll kind of see how that fits. Both of them on the inside, I think they're about the same. I think they have the same layout. Yeah, all of the pockets on the inside are the same. So the only thing different is a little bit of the size, but the ring spacing is all the same. And so these should all work together. So I'm just gonna pull all of these out of here and we will just see. So I'm gonna leave the cash envelopes in for now because those aren't gonna be part of it. I think they would just take up too much room in there. So I'm gonna set this aside for right now. And I'm going to take out the weekly ones and then we'll just start from scratch. Okay, so both of these, let's see. Oh, it's sticking, it doesn't want to come apart. Okay, so both of these come with these plastic flyleaf page protectors. And then I think there's some in the back too. So I'm gonna take out all of those. And we'll just set those aside. Okay, so some of the things that I have here, and this is like not sorted at all. So here's another, just a clear flyleaf. I have some decorative ones and all of, except for the dividers, all of these are ones I've kind of just made myself. So either I printed them out or I just cut out scrapbook paper, something like that. So I have some vellums. These are just like some dashboards. Let's actually set this aside and we'll sort through these. Okay, so there's some vellum. This, I actually really like this combination. And so I wanted to see how this would look with the blue. So I'm not going to separate those two right now. There's another vellum. This one is a laminated vellum. So I'm still going to stick that right there. And I'm going to put this one with the vellum. It's a sheet of acetate. So that can go there too. And then here's some of my dividers. So these dividers are from Filofax, and they are very slippery apparently. So I have that set. I have these clear plastic ones that I got from Amazon. And then I have another set. These ones are also from Filofax. And I think these are actually my favorite. These ones are the clear ones, are probably the ones I'm gonna use. I don't know, we'll line it up and see what colors match best with the binder. Then I have some lined note paper. And just some little extra things. So here's a today dashboard, another little dashboard thing, some pockets, inbox, a zipper pocket, same as the other one, a larger pocket, and then some folders. So this looks kind of rough, but this is what I have as of right now to work with. First of all, I think I kind of want to look at the dividers and see which one's going to work better with the blue. I'm kind of leaning towards these ones just because of the colors of it. I think the clear would also work really well too. But see, look how well those work with the blue. I think those match really nicely. And then the other set, even these ones look nice, but I do think I like the other ones better. But then of course there's the clear ones too. But I think I'm gonna go with these ones from Filofax. So we'll just move these aside. And I don't know if I will need all of them because I don't think I'm gonna have six sections. I'm thinking it might be four, but I'm not positive yet, so we'll see how it goes. And then for the folder, kind of wanna see, I think I like this one right here. I like the dark contrast, plus those little butterflies are so cute. So I think I'm just gonna put that in the back right now. And then we'll work on these in a minute. I think we're just gonna leave the dividers right there. So the first thing that I wanna put in is my weekly pages. So I'm gonna pick out the 3 months of those and we'll put those in behind the first tab. We'll do all the decorating stuff at the end. But so there's the first one. I'm gonna have to move some of this out of the way. Okay, let's try it this way. All right, so here's the Clever Fox Weekly Planner. And if you wanna see the full review and flip through of this, I will link to both this one and the budget one in the descriptions and possibly in the cards up here. I can't do both of them at the same time in the cards, but they will be linked in the description below in case you wanna look at those ones. So the Clever Fox, we have the intro page, and then at the very beginning, they have some goal pages. And so I'm going to put those behind their own tab. And I'm just gonna do all of it, even though it's like a full year's worth. So then after that, it goes into the month and then the review. So we're gonna do 3 months worth, review, third, and the review. Okay, so we'll take that out and set this aside. Another thing I actually wanna do is separate the months from the goal pages at the beginning, give them their own section. So we're gonna actually put a divider in right here. So here's the goals and all of the prep work type pages. And then I'm going to put in the next divider and do my monthly calendars in here. And then we'll put another one in and we'll do the weekly pages in its own divider. Okay, so now that I'm looking at this, what I think I'm actually going to do is take out one of these pages. So it's the last page of the monthly review and then the calendar that I'm not using, but I'm going to replace it with the end of this monthly section because it goes right into the weekly pages. And so even though it's going to be splitting up the monthly review, I think I'm just going to go with it and we'll just start the weekly pages there. So I'm going to count out what 3 months of the weekly pages would be. I'll probably do about 12, 13 weeks, something like that. And then I will be back and we'll put it in. Okay, so I actually did 14 weeks just to make sure that I had enough. So here's my divider for the weekly section. We'll put that in. Oh, actually I want it before this page. So we're gonna split up the monthly review with the divider and then all of the weekly pages can go behind there. So there's my weekly section. So I'm going to take my next divider and now we're going to create the budget section. So similarly, this has the front page and it has some goal setting things right at the beginning. I think there's not as many though. Let's see. Okay, so we have that page, the goals, strategy and tactics, and then it goes into the months. So I want 3 months worth. So we'll grab the green section, teal. I like that they're color-coded because it's helping me just be able to distinguish between the months. It makes it a lot easier to separate them that way. Okay, so there's my 3 months worth of budget pages and we'll set those aside and add in my next divider. And for this last one, I'm actually just gonna put in some notepaper. This is just some notepaper I had laying around. And so this back tab is going to be my notes section. Now I do have another divider here. So if there was something else that I wanted to add, I definitely have room to put in another one just using this set of six dividers, but I don't have anything else I want to put in here at the moment. And so I'm just going to leave it with this and it'll just have the five. All right, so now it's time to add in all of our decorations. I've looked through these a little bit, so I kind of have an idea of what I want to do, but I'm not like completely certain yet. So I really love this sunflower. And I kind of like that one too. I'm not necessarily using all of these. I'm just picking out my favorites right now, just to kind of see what they look like. Here's all the little extras. Let's pull those out separate. All right, and like I said, I really like this one. And then this is the clear one that goes on the front. Oh, you can't even see, but yeah, there's a clear one here. I'm gonna skip these ones. We'll see about this one because I like the bows and I kind of like this one with the blue. I think it looks really nice and I think I'm going to skip that one for now. So let's try something with these and see what we want to do. And I may need to pull in more if I need more for different sections. Usually when I'm setting up an A5 binder, I just put something on the front. I don't usually put things like dashboards behind each tab. And partially for me, that's because when I turn the tab, I like it to go straight to what I'm working on. I don't want to have to flip through extra pages. And I do have my little A5 hole punch here because some of these are not punched yet. So I really like this combination together. I think it's really pretty and I think it matches the binder really well. And so I think I'm going to punch this one and this is going to be one of my main ones on the front. So if we take these and just line them up. I'm always worried that I'm going to punch things in the wrong spot. And so let's hope I don't. Okay, it looks like it turned out okay. So I'm going to open it up again. And so we'll put that one right on front. So I can still see my tabs next to it, but it does cover up that green, having the white paper there, so it doesn't show through on the vellum. But I think this is really cool because it just looks like dandelions on a sunset. And so I think that's really pretty. And I'm happy with that. Let's see what else we have. So I have the other dandelion vellum, but I think I'm going to put that to the side. I really like this Bose one, but I don't know if I want it as the paper where you can put vellum over it or as the vellum where you put something under it. And I have this other sky one, which would kind of go with the theme. And I could do that. No, I don't like that. Okay, what else? There's also this. Oh, that looks kind of cool. I think I like that. And I really like this sunflower too. This combination's not really matching the theme I'm going for, and so I don't know if I will do this unless I find something else to put the sunflower on. But even the sunflower kind of has a brown tint to it, so it does match this. But I actually don't like how it covers up the words there, and so this combination together is not my favorite. Oh, and while I'm thinking about it, let's put this clear one over here. Okay, I really like that. All right, so I need to punch this one and this one. So now those two are ready to go. I think that one's already punched, yes. So the dots are punched. Do I like that? I kind of do like that. Okay, so I'm trying to debate if I should close them again or just avoid opening and closing them as much as possible. Because I'm pretty sure that's how you make the rings last longer, is by not opening and closing them a lot. Why is that? There we go. Okay. So after we have this little intro section, let's put the Be Intentional one there because that's like the goal section. Put it this way. And then after the monthly, the holes on the Filofax ones are really small, so sometimes you kind of have to wiggle them around to get them in the right spot. This is the monthly ones, right? Let's do something else for the monthly. I want to put this one on the weekly, so I'll leave that for a second, and I'll put the weekly here. And I'm not going to put anything after the notes one, so I won't need anything for there. But I think I do want something for the monthly and then for the budget. So let's go back and see what I have here. Okay, what did I do? This goes right here. Okay, there we go. Wondering why I had an extra tab. Okay, so I have my last two that I'm going to use. So this one I'm going to use over the weekly. It's a sheet of vellum that I printed on, and then this one is a sheet of vellum scrapbook paper that I cut out to size and then laminated. And it doesn't work if I put the flowers on top of the other vellum, but if I do it this way, then I can still see the flowers underneath. So I'm going to do it that way. And that is going to go in my weekly section and then in my budget section. Okay, so I'm going to have to close it because that's just too many pages to turn. Okay, so then for my budget section, I have this sheet of flowery vellum, and then I have this quote that I really love. And because it's a goal-related quote, I think it works really well for the budget section. And so I'm just going to put that over my budget pages, and I will call that good for decorations. The last thing that I want to add in is maybe some of these little extras. This one I thought would be good for stickers. It's just like a sheet protector. I have the zipper pocket too, and then inbox, and then some bookmarks, and then this other pocket that has some stickers in it. So I probably won't use this one just because I have this one that already has the stickers in it. And I think I actually want to kind of spread them out just so I can see more of the colors at one time. Okay, so I put them all in and I did it double-sided so I can actually see all of the sheets, and so I know exactly what colors I have. I definitely want to use these as my bookmarks, and then I might throw the inbox one in too just because I love having an inbox in my planners just as a brain dump for whatever else I need. So first in the back, I'm going to put in these two, and I'm going to put them right before the pocket folder but after the notes pages. And these can be good for just holding any little random things. I could put some sticky notes in here, or like sheets of stickers, things like that. I actually have some budgeting stickers that came with the planner, and so I will probably put those in the pocket in the back. And so there's that one. And now, actually, let's do this one in here too. See, I'm just trying not to open and close it, and now I'm doing it all the time. All right, let's go back to the front. So right after my little dashboard here, I'm going to put in this inbox. And the way I would be most likely to use this is just to write my notes on sticky notes and then put them directly on here so that I can keep track of them. Then when I'm done with it, I can just throw it away and don't have to bother with it anymore. All right, so now we're going to turn the pages back over, try to get them all to line up. So here's the goal section. So I'm not going to put a bookmark in there, but I want one in the monthly and I want one in the weekly pages. So here's my monthly. So we'll turn to the first monthly calendar, and I'm going to put this one in here. I probably should have cleaned it off before I did it. I was testing my wet erase markers, but I didn't, so it has little scribbles all over it. And then here's the weekly section. Another thing I do like about having the dashboards here is that it covers up these like middle pages that I'm not actually using, and then I can just use this to go straight into my week. All right, so we'll close that up and I think we are done. So we can flip through it. It is a little full on the rings. You know, I actually probably could, let's take out some of this. I'm gonna leave the stickers, but I think I'm gonna take out these two extra pockets because I think they're just bulking it up and I don't think they're necessary. This pocket should be just fine, plus the pockets that are in the planner itself. And so maybe that will help. Yeah, that made a big difference. So I think that actually works really well. It closes, it fits nicely, and I think it's just the right size. So we'll do that. So let's grab the budgeting stickers. So those are tucked in here. So I'm actually just going to take these and put them in this folder in the back. I think that'll be the way to make them the most accessible. And then I just have the other side of the folder for anything else that I just need to keep in this planner. And then I also brought over just some cute little things in case we wanted to use them. These are just some cards that I made. I made them for like washi cards, but then I never actually put washi on them. I just thought they were cute. So they're just like digital scrapbook papers that I printed and cut small, and then I just laminated them. So now they're just cute little cards. So I like to use these for decorations. So I can just slide these in here. They're a little bit tight just because they have the lamination on them. I think if you had like normal cards, they would fit fine. These are a little bit bigger than like normal credit cards and things like that. But that should be good for there. And then I have this cute little Hello Kitty sticker. And I brought over some Ollie clips. I wasn't sure which one I wanted, if I wanted the big one or the small one. But I always like to have Ollie clips with my planners, especially with ring planners, because then I can just mark the pages that I go to frequently. And that way, so like if I have, just as an example, if there's a certain page of the goals that I want to get to, like the vision board, I can actually use the Ollie clip and just clip it over the whole divider. And then when I open up the divider, it turns right to the page that I want. So Ollie clips are just one of my favorite little planner accessories to use. And they work really well. They're very thin, but they're very strong. So I can put this one in here. And then I was thinking about using this little tiny one to hold the little Hello Kitty on. I don't know how it's going to work because it's probably just going to cover up her face. But I thought it would be cute to have there. And then I just have these little transparent sticky notes. And I think I'm just going to use this one. And I'm just going to slip it right back here. And I think we're done. I think this is the planner setup. So just to do one quick flip through, I have all my cute decorations here with the transparent sticky notes in the pocket. I have this dashboard that has the dandelions on it. I know it's, there we go. Now you don't have the glare, but I have my dandelion dashboard on here, and I love dandelions. They make me very happy. There's my inbox divider, which, you know, I think I'm actually going to take that out too. Hold on. Okay. That was a little thick and it was making it hard to turn this page, so I did take that out too. So again, I have my dashboard here. My first tab goes into the goal setting of the Clever Fox weekly planner. And then my next tab goes into my monthly section. I have my second dashboard there and my divider to mark the month that I'm on. And then each month has a review after it, so all of those pages are in here. In the weekly section, of course, another dashboard. And then it goes into the week with my today bookmark. And then all of my weekly pages for 3 months are in here. And then we go into the budget section where I have the first 3 months of the budget planner. And then some notes pages in the back, some stickers in a pocket, a little paper pocket folder, and that's the end of it. So let me know in the comments what you think, what you would do differently. I'd love to hear how you would set this up. I think this is really fun, and I love the option of having multiple types of planners all within a ring-bound system. And I really do hope Clever Fox continues with this line and does more planners that are made for an A5 ring system. Thank you so much for watching today. I hope you had fun with this, and I will talk to you later. Have a great day. Bye-bye.